to the next maths class. And before I start the class, I want to request you all to please log in with your name and class with section. Okay, children? Those who are logging with their phone names and all, we will remove them. And then you can change your name with class and section, and then you can re-enter the Zoom class. Is it clear, children? Please cooperate with us. Okay? And I hope I am audible to you. And please put on your cameras and your mic should be off. You have to mute yourself, but your camera should be on. Is it clear, children? Okay, good, children. Now, yesterday we had the Zoom class for this number and numeration. So I am quickly going to revise what we did yesterday. Okay, so yesterday I told you about the Indian place value system. Okay, Indian numeration system. There you in class 3, you have studied ones and thousands. Still thousands, 4-digit numbers you have studied. In ones, there are 3 places. Ones, tens, hundreds. And in thousands, there are 2 places. Thousands and ten thousands. But today, in this revision part, we will revise only till thousands place. Is it clear, children? So, the value of ones is 1. Tens is 10. Hundreds is 100 and thousands is 1000. Now, I will quickly place this number, the digits of this number in the place value chart according to their places. We start from the extreme right. Okay, so this digit, first digit will go in the ones place, 2. This next digit will go in the next higher place, tens. The next digit, 3, will go in the next higher place, that is hundreds place. This is 3 here, and this 4 will go in the thousands place. So how will you read this number? This number we will read with their places. 4,000, 300, and last 2 places are read together, 92. Is it clear, children? So this number will be read as read and written as 4,392. Got it, children? Similarly, we will do with these 2 numbers. This is 7056. We will place it according to their positions in the place value chart. The 6 will go in the ones place, 5 in the tens place, 0 in the hundreds place, and 7 in the thousands place. So now, how will you read this number? Yes, 7000. There is 0 in the hundreds place. You will skip it. 0 means nothing. So you will skip that place. So it will be 7056. Got it? Now, the next number, 9208. So again, you will place 8 in the ones place, 0 in the tens place, 2 in the hundreds place, and 9 in the thousands place. So now, how will you read it? Now, as you can see, that 0 is in the tens place means nothing. There is no number there. So you have to skip that place. So you will read this number like 9208. Got it, children? Okay. Now we will understand the place value. I told you the place value, the number where it is sitting, where is the position of that digit in the number. We will multiply that digit with the value of the number place and you will get the place value. For example, I will take this number 7056. In this, you have to find out the place value of 7. Okay, now this 7, where is this 7? Here, in the thousands place, and the value of thousands place is 1000. So you will multiply this number with the thousand value and you will get the place value 7000. Is it clear, children? This is how you determine the place value. If any number is in, suppose you want to find out the place value of this 5, then what will you do? This 5 is in the tens place, so you will multiply this 5 with 10 and you will get the place value of this 5. 5 into 10 is equal to 50. Have you understood? Children, I want to remind you again that no need to write this step. This is just for your explanation. You can directly write the place value like this, 7,000 or 50. Got it? Okay. So this is how we determine the place value. Now we come to the face value. Face value is very easy. Face value, your face remains same whether you are in class 2 or 3 or 4. Is it or not? Okay, so the face remains same. If I go to teach in class 2, there also my name will be Ruchi Garg. If I am teaching here in class 4, then also my name is Ruchi Garg. Okay, similarly, the value, face value of the digit remains the same, whether it is in ones place, tens place, hundreds place, thousands place, or any place. Okay, so if I take this number 9,208, okay, now in the face value of 9, what is the face value of 9? Face value of 9 will be 9 only. Suppose this 9 is sitting in hundreds place. Okay, now I write another number. Now what is the face value of this 9? It will be 9 only. Is it clear, children? So the face value of the digit remains same irrespective of the position it is in. Okay, children, got it? So yesterday we revised till here. Now today, we will revise how to determine which number is bigger or which number is smaller. That means comparison of numbers. Now, comparison of numbers is also very easy. I am going to write two numbers here. Let's see. Now, how will you start comparing the numbers? When we compare the numbers, we start from the extreme left. That means that is the highest position of the digit in a number. Highest place. Highest place. This is ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. Thousands is the highest place. Here also ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. Both the numbers are four digit numbers. So thousands is the highest place. So first we will compare the highest place. Here it is 2 and here it is 3. That means it is 2000 and here it is 3000. So which number is bigger? 2000 or 3000? Naturally, 3000. So this number is bigger. Okay, you know this sign? How to use this sign? This is the open mouth of the crocodile. So it wants to eat the bigger number. So it will open towards the bigger number. Got it? Now I take another example. This number, 4,763, and this number is 4,561. Just now I told you that we start from the highest place. In both the numbers, highest place is thousands. But there is again one twist. Thousands place, both the numbers are having same digit. This is also 4,000, this is also 4,000. So what will we do? We will move to the next lower place. After thousands, hundreds place will come. Here it is 7 and here it is 5. So this is 4,700 and this is 4,500. So which number is bigger, 7 or 5? Yes, 7 is bigger. So this number will be bigger. So the symbol will be this. The open mouth of this crocodile will eat the bigger number. So it will be facing this side. So this 4,763 is bigger than 4,561. Similarly, if suppose hundreds place is also same, we will move to the tens place. And if tens place is also same, we will move to the ones place and compare the digits. And if all the digits are same, that means both the numbers are equal. Is it clear to you, children? Very good. And children, I want to remind you that you have to do all this work which we are doing just now in your rough copy. This will be helpful to you when you do the worksheets. Okay? Now, We have understood how to compare the numbers. Now I want to teach you the next step in this ascending and descending order. You all know what is ascending and descending order. Ascending means going up. Ascend, going up from low to big, from small to big. And descending, coming down. Coming down means from up to low. So from big to small. So when you know how to compare the numbers, you can easily arrange them in the ascending or the descending order. Let us write few numbers here. I have written these four numbers here. Okay. One is 2,694, 1,358, 6,009, and next is 1,299. Now you have to arrange them in ascending order. Ascending order. You all know ascending order means going up from small to big. From small to big. So now which is the smallest number out of these four? So what will you do? You will compare the thousands base, because all the digits are four digits. So that is same. So now we will compare the thousands base of all the four numbers. Here it is 2, here it is 1, here it is 6, here also it is 1. So these two numbers are the smallest in this group. Now, out of these two numbers, which one is the smallest? So, because the thousands place is same, we will go to the hundreds place. So, hundreds place here is 3 and there it is 2. So, this number is the smallest of all. Okay. So, this number is the smallest of all. So, first we will write this number 1,299. And the next number will be? Higher number is, now that number is, we have already written. So these three numbers are left. So out of these three numbers, this is the smallest. So we will next write this number, 1,358. Okay. Now the next higher number, now two numbers are left. 2,694 and 6,009. So we will again compare the thousands place. So which is the thousands place? 2 and 6. And which is smaller than that? 2. So this number will come the next. 2,694. Okay. And now which is the greatest number left? 6,009. So we will write 6,009. So now we have arranged these numbers in the ascending order from small to big. Is it clear, children? Okay. Okay. Now I will write another set of numbers and we will arrange those numbers in descending order. I have written these four numbers. Let's read them first. 4,620, 8,519, 3,067, and 5,281. Is it clear, children? Now you have to arrange them in descending order. Okay. And as you know, descending order is just the opposite of ascending order, means from big to small. like you descend the stairs. Descend the stairs means from up first floor you are going to the ground floor. Okay, from big to small, up to down. Okay, so from big to small. Okay, now again we will compare. The method of comparison is same. We will compare the thousands place, highest place. So highest place in all these four numbers we will compare. Here it is 4,000, here it is 8,000, here it is 3,000, and there it is 5,000. So which is the biggest? Naturally 8,000. So this number is the biggest, 8,519. So we will write this number here, 8,519. Now removing this number, three numbers are left. We will compare those three numbers. Now which is the biggest thousand place? 4,000, 3,000, 5,000. Naturally 5,000, yes. So we will write this number in the next place. Now these two numbers are over. We have already written them. So these two numbers are left. Now here it is 4,000, here it is 3,000. So out of these two numbers, which is the bigger one? Yes, 4,620. So we will write this number here. And in the last place, this number is left. So this will come 3,067. Okay, children, have you understood the ascending order and descending order? Yes, very good. This is just a revision you have been doing in class 3 and you all are good students. So please just do a quick revision of all these things. Okay, children? Okay. Now next, we will study successor and predecessor. Now this you have studied in class 3, successor and predecessor. What do you mean by this? Successor means what comes ahead. Suppose I am the digit, I am a number. So what comes after me, that is successor. And what comes before me, that is the predecessor. So successor means plus one. How will you determine a number successor? Successor means you add one to the given number and you will get the successor. Predecessor, you subtract one to the given number and you will get the predecessor. For example, we take this number only, 4,620. What is the successor of this? You add one and you know 4,620, you will add one, you will get 4,621. This is the successor of this. And if you want to find the predecessor of the same number, what will you do? You will subtract one. Then you will get the predecessor. So if you subtract one from this number, naturally you will get 4,619. You are well versed with the numbers by now. I know this. Okay. So this is the successor. And this is the predecessor. Have you understood this, children? How to find out the successor and the predecessor? So now I'll just give you a sum up of today's class. Today again we revised about the place values, how to read the numbers, how to write their names, that is called numeration. And then we studied about the place value. Wherever the digit is sitting in the place, we multiply that digit with the value of that place and you get the place value. Face value, it remains same throughout everywhere. Okay, wherever the digit, you recognize this digit. Suppose you recognize this digit by 7. So this will remain 7 only wherever it is. Okay, then we started the comparison of numbers. We start the comparison from the highest place, extreme left, and then we start comparing. The number of digits should be same when we are comparing the number. Okay, so then ascending and descending order we started. Ascending means from small to big, and descending means from big to small. So you know we start comparing from the highest place, and as we, if the that place is same, we move to the next place. Like this you will compare and arrange them in ascending or descending order. Then we studied successor and predecessor. If you add one to the given number, if I'm asking you the successor of a particular number, to that particular number you add one and you will get the successor. And if to that particular number you subtract one, you will get the predecessor. Is it clear, children? I hope you all have understood. Revise this. You can revise from your old book. And please, children, again, I'm requesting you all to log in with your name, class, ID, and your section, with your uniform. Please come with your uniform, sit with your uniform. Let us see your smart faces. Okay. So please log in daily. You have to log in with your name, class, and section is also very important. Is it clear? Please don't compel us to remind you again and again and again the same thing. You all are intelligent children, smart children. So please follow the instructions given. Okay, children. Now, in the next class, we will study about the rounding off and the odd even numbers. Okay. Thank you, children. Let's revise the successor and predecessor once more. Successor means plus one, means you have to add one. Suppose what will be the successor of this? So now tell me. Successor of, what will be the successor of this? Yes, plus one you will do and you will get 3217. What will be the successor of, you have to do this yourself. I am giving you two numbers. You will write the successor of these in your rough copy. Okay. Got it? You will write the successor of these numbers. And there I am giving you the homework for predecessors. Now suppose, what will be the predecessor of this? 4,366 minus 1. So that will be 4,365. Okay. I am giving you two more numbers. Do it in your homework. Okay. This is 6060. So you write the predecessor of these two numbers. Yes, you can subtract one and find out, work out in your rough column, subtract one, and then you can find out the predecessor of these two numbers. Is it clear, children? So this is how you will find out the successor and the predecessors of numbers. Okay. And place value also you have understood. Now, comparison of numbers also you have understood. Okay, children. So, today we have revised. Again, I have revised the portion which we did yesterday. Those who missed the class yesterday, they must have understood now the place value and the face value, numeration, reading the numbers and all. Is it clear, children? So, children, now let us do odd and even numbers. Children, again and again, I'm getting this that you are not logging in with your name, class, and section. Please, I'm requesting for the third time in this class that please log in with your name, otherwise name, class, and section. Otherwise, you will be removed from the class. Is it clear? Now, you have got single digit numbers. How many we have? Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and here we can say 0. 10 ka ones place is 0. So these are the single digit numbers. Now, out of all these 10 digits, we have grouped them in two groups, in which are 0, 2, 4, 6, and 8. And another group is 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. Okay. This group is called even group. And this group is called odd group. Now, how will you determine odd and even? If any number has these out of any of these digits in the ones place, then that number will be even. And if any number is having any one of these digits in ones place, they will be odd. So now we'll continue with this odd and even in the next session. So for this, you can just revise it and try to study on your own. And then we'll continue with it tomorrow. Okay. Thank you, children.